just a Friday at Tel Aviv. It's fine.
Exactly. So I started recording when you said that. So we have Dave West with us, and you're on camera now at the Business Agility Conference BU in Boston.
Hi, this is Dave West. So the first question was about how do you track your retrospective items, the things that you learn at your retrospective. Well, obviously you have to make them transparent. It wouldn't be very Scrum if you didn't. So yes, you can put them in JIRA. I know that comment was don't put them in JIRA. Well, maybe put them in a different JIRA then if your developers don't want it polluting your product backlog and your sprint backlog. But it definitely has to go somewhere. And then ultimately, you have to then review that item at your next retrospective, the item that you picked to improve during the next sprint. Now, honestly, it means that it has to reside in the sprint backlog as well as you're doing work, as you break it down, because maybe it's a big thing that requires some level of decomposition. So make it visible. I don't mind how. Obviously, if you're using JIRA, maybe you create a board or a repository full of those retrospective improvement items, and then you manage it in a board and you show progress against them every sprint. And then remember at the retro to talk a little bit about the thing that you tried to improve last sprint. And I think that would help massively.
Dave, thank you very much. I'm gonna pan here while I'm recording so we see where we are. Dave West, thank you so much.
You're very welcome.